Hey, did you know that it would take over 59,000 years to read every book that's been published? And that doesn't include the roughly 1 million additional books that are published every single year. So that means that you have to be very selective with what books you read and how you read them. Now, the good news is that I've put together 7 books that every entrepreneur should read. So make sure you watch until the end because book number 6 is my personal favorite. And also don't forget to like this video if you're excited to take your entrepreneurial skills to another level. Let's dive right in. So the first book I recommend is The Road Less Stupid. And this book lays the perfect foundation for entrepreneurship and running a company. It's designed for high-level entrepreneurial thinking that produces big results. So here are a few actionable insights from this book. So the underlying theme of the book is that the key to getting rich and growing your financial wealth is to avoid making stupid decisions. And the way you can do that is through dedicated thinking time. And one of the biggest drivers of bad decision making in business comes from emotion. And the author argues that when emotions go up, intellect goes down. In fact, Warren Buffett said that optimism is the enemy of the rational investor. And this same concept applies to entrepreneurs as well. Now, the one thing I love about this book is that it tackles each component of running a business and then gives you thinking time prompts at the end of every chapter. And these questions will force you to think about your actions and your business at an entirely different level. Now, the author recommends dedicating 30 to 45 minutes of uninterrupted thinking time every single day. Now, the second book I recommend is critical for having the right mindset in life. Ironically, the book is called Mindset. And it's easily one of the most life-changing books because it explains the difference between a fixed mindset and a growth mindset. In short, a fixed mindset is when you think that all of your qualities are set in stone. For example, someone with a fixed mindset believes that IQ matters and will determine whether someone is successful or not. In other words, someone's potential and ceiling is based on a fixed metric. And as a result, everything becomes a self-fulfilling prophecy. For example, if you think you can't be successful because of X, Y, and Z, then you'll likely act in accordance with that belief. You'll start to seek out information to confirm that belief even more. And as a result, you'll become what you've conditioned yourself to be. Now, the opposite mindset is what is called a growth mindset. With this mindset, you believe that the hand you're dealt is just the starting point for your development. And with a growth mindset, you believe you can change and grow through application and experience. There is no ceiling and there is nothing stopping you from doing what it takes to become who you want to be. Now, the key is to remember that everyone starts at a different position. For example, some people are raised in low-income households without access to opportunities, while some people are raised in high-income households with an abundance of opportunities. Each person must act based on the hand they are dealt. Now, the good news is that 80% of millionaires are self-made, and that's because most of them refuse to be tied down by a limiting fixed mindset. And to be honest, I haven't found a single successful entrepreneur who doesn't have a growth mindset. It's absolutely critical to adopt a growth mindset if you want to succeed in anything, especially in entrepreneurship. So the third book I recommend is The War of Art, and I've read and reread this book countless times. I also have all my notes transcribed for you to download, and I'll have a link in the description box below this video. That said, The War of Art is about unlocking your creativity so you can produce real value in the world. Now, the key part to achieving everything you want in life is to consistently overcome what Stephen Pressfield calls resistance. For example, Pressfield argues that the more important a call or action is to our soul's revolution, the more resistance we will feel towards pursuing it. And some manifestations of resistance are procrastination, self-pity, and victim mentality. Now, the key to overcoming this idea of resistance is simple. You need to do the work every single day. You have to reframe your mind and become a professional instead of an amateur. Now, here's an exact quote to emphasize this point even more. The amateur plays for fun, the professional plays for keeps. The amateur plays part-time, the professional full-time. The amateur is a weekend warrior, the professional is there 7 days a week. Now, the fourth book I highly recommend is Seeking Wisdom. Now, out of all the books I've recommended thus far, this one will require the most concentration and thought to read. And that's because it's extremely deep and will make you question almost everything you think about life. And I'm not even exaggerating. Now, the reason why I love it is because it focuses heavily on human behavior and psychology. And I personally believe that understanding and studying how humans think and act is fundamental to your success as an entrepreneur. Now, there are too many takeaways from this book to mention here, but here are three ideas to think about. First, you have to understand the time value of money. In short, money paid in the future is worth less than money paid today. And that's because you'll have less time to take advantage of compound interest. In short, you want your money to earn interest as soon as possible to get the full effect of compounding. For example, if you invest $2,500 each year for 40 years at a 10% return, you will have $1 million in assets. Now, the second big takeaway from this book is that the fear of loss is much greater than the desire to gain. This is a critical concept to understand if you're trying to improve your marketing or sales. For example, go to Amazon and you'll see how they're tapping into this principle with their Fire tablets. Notice that there's a supposed price reduction on their Fire tablets and that it's a limited time offer. They are creating urgency and tension through the use of scarcity and deadlines. And it works insanely well because of our inherent fear of loss. I recommend tapping into this when you're trying to sell more of your products because it works. And the last takeaway is that praise is more effective in changing behavior than punishment. Now, sure, you'll see extreme examples like Steve Jobs, who would berate his employees, but he was an exception, not the rule. If you want to motivate team members, focus on what they're doing well, not what they're insufficient in. Start with positive feedback before introducing negative feedback. And this simple switch can have a profound effect on how you treat your team members and how they perceive you and their work. Now, the fifth book every entrepreneur should read is The E-Myth. This book is critical if you want to build a company that can grow and operate without you doing everything. Now, the truth is you don't have a company until it can operate without you. And it's not an easy thing to do, and I'm personally still working on it myself, but The E-Myth will give you the framework you need to start building a real company. Now, the truth is you'll never truly separate yourself from your company unless you sell and relinquish control. For example, although Jeff Bezos isn't doing granular tasks at Amazon, he's still working hundreds of hours a week running the company. He's just working at a higher level. He didn't just stop working once he built the systems and teams to run Amazon. And the only way he would be able to truly separate himself from Amazon is if he resigned from his position as CEO and became an investor. Now, the point is that your goal of systemizing your business isn't to stop working. The goal is to get away from low-value tasks so you can focus all of your thought and effort on the high-impact actions. And The E-Myth is the best book to help you start making that transition. So the sixth book, which is my personal favorite book on this list, is called Cashvertising. So I'm a marketer at heart, so I'm absolutely obsessed with this book. In fact, I read it for the first time on my Kindle and loved it so much that I ordered a physical copy so I could go through it again. And I've read and reread this book more than any other book. It's absolutely incredible. So what is it? Cashvertising basically compiled all the psychological principles from books like Influence into a single book. So if you want more leads, customers, and sales for your company, then this is the book you need to read and execute on. Now, one of the most important concepts in this book is what the author calls the Life Force 8. In short, human beings are biologically programmed with the following 8 desires. Number 1, survival, enjoyment of life, and life extension. Number 2, enjoyment of food and beverages. Number 3, freedom from fear, pain, and danger. Number 4, sexual companionship. Number 5, comfortable living conditions. Number 6, to be superior, winning, keeping up with the Joneses. Number 7, care and protection of loved ones. And number 8, social approval. Now, all of your marketing and advertising should appeal to one or more of these desires. Now, trust me when I say this, when you switch your messaging and creative to attack these desires, your revenue will grow rapidly. And I recommend watching advertisements that keep you engaged and have persuaded you to buy in the past. I guarantee that they're using one or more of the Life Force 8 desires. That said, Cashvertising is the type of book where you're highlighting things on every single page, and it's actionable and can actually help you grow your company. So the seventh and final book that every entrepreneur should read is Pitch Anything. Now, there are a lot of nonsense sales books out there that focus on self-help instead of practical advice. Pitch Anything does the opposite. It focuses on the tactical and psychological side of sales and persuasion. Like Cashvertising, you'll find yourself reading every word and highlighting constantly. Now, here are a few big takeaways from Pitch Anything. First, use acts of defiance to take control of business situations. For example, let's say the prospect says they only have 15 minutes. Then you would say with a smile, "That's great because I only have 12 minutes." The author argues that defiance and light humor are the keys to seizing power. Now, the second takeaway is to never let the prospect change the agenda, the meeting time, or who will attend. You need to dictate these terms or you'll be put into an inferior position. And I know it's crazy to think that these things matter, but they do. Every nuanced detail matters when it comes to business situations. Pitch Anything will prepare you for these nuances and make you a better sales and business person. So those are seven of my go-to books for becoming a better entrepreneur. So now to you. Have you read or want to read any of these books? Let me know what book you've read or want to read in the comment section below this video. So with that said, if you got value from this video, please like it and subscribe to my channel because I publish new videos every week. Thank you so much for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.